because of secularism, man is no longer answerable to God. He is just answerable to his fellow man. God is no longer a motive for him to do good or to be honest. And if you are just answerable to man in terms of justice, integrity, what is the motivation for you to live a life of integrity? And if you're just answering to man, then the question is, well, if I don't get caught, it is okay. So I can do anything, but don't get caught. Because human beings are by nature selfish. That's the reason why we still have so many crimes in the world today. In secularism, it leads to a situation where a person no longer has the capacity to serve with altruistic motive. Why does a person sacrifice himself for others if he doesn't believe in God? If he doesn't believe in the consequences of actions that are done today, if these actions have no eternal consequences, then what is the motive for doing good? If it's based on humanitarian reason, I don't think we go very far. Even that humanitarian motive can lead to an excessive retaliation, because people are not interested in the cause that you are promoting. So in the end, they become angry because not everybody is with them for the same cause. Can we say that we have proclaimed the gospel simply because we have done good works? What is the gospel that we are called to proclaim at the end of the day? The gospel is to give the fullness of life to everyone. A person can be intellectually nurtured, materially, physically, taken care of. But is that what will fulfill a person's life? The happiest people are in those countries where there is emotional, spiritual fulfillment. What is human development? Human development means intellectual, it means physical, it means affective, it means moral, it means spiritual. You cannot deny that every human person, in order to be happy, must be morally and spiritually formed. If humanity were to fully blossom, somehow the secular world must bring religion back to society, because they cannot provide the two dimensions, the moral and the spiritual. Technology and science without morality will be disasters. Without morality, science and technology is a double-edged sword. We can use science and technology for the progress or for destruction. We must go back to the Word of God. We must take direction from the Lord. We need to truly ask ourselves, how can we help humanity to reclaim the fullness of life? How can we help humanity to grow in an integral manner, physically, affectively, morally, spiritually, and the rest?